Hi there, I'm announcer of games, and we all know why you're here. We all know exactly why you're here. Your group needs a DM, and you have been thrusted into this position, and you don't know where to start. Well, I have the perfect means of helping you. So, sit back, relax, open those damn ears like your players should, and here are 8 tips to being a good DM.
Step 1. Never say no unless you absolutely have to. Basically, always say no to something that's really, really bad. Like trying to force a sexual encounter, or a player trying to like fuck over the rest of the party that doesn't contribute to the party at all, and really just is gonna mess with the fun of the game. That is the only time you should say no. Any other time, never say no. If it involves the players just goofing around or basically just playing their character, let them do it. If their character wants to cast Fireball when the players are all in a mass battle, that's their consequence to take for doing it. And yeah, it's your job to just hold on to that no until you absolutely have to use it. Step 2. Always encourage your players both on and off the table. Basically what I mean by this, just encourage your players to get into the game a little bit more, whether it be like taking notes or just getting their character backstory down. Encourage them, don't force them. It's one thing to be encouraging, it's another thing to basically be in their face and say, "You have to do this!" Most players are shy, and it's gonna take a bit for them to get comfortable with the group that they're with. So, just be patient and encourageable to them. Step 3. Always listen to what your players have to say both before, during, and after a session. Basically, criticism is your best ally in this instance. Figuring out what worked for your party, what didn't work for your party, or is currently what is and what's not working for your table. It's really easy, just ask your players what they thought of the campaign so far. This can range from negative opinions to positive opinions, but it's always good to listen to the opinions of your players. Now, sometimes you can discard what they say if it's just stupid rule fudging at that point, but always listen to what your players have to say. Step 4. Prepare a week in advance, or at least a few days before the session starts. Listen, you don't show up to work with your pants down, you don't show up to your wedding without your nice dress or your suit. I don't judge, but I do judge when a DM comes very, very, very badly unprepared. Like, nothing at all is prepared, and he just improvs it the entire time. Because that's what I did in my first few years of DMing, and it was annoying. Please come prepared. That means maps drawn, characters understood, notes taken. And remember to ask your players if you forgot something. You are not perfect. You are not expected to be perfect, but please be as prepared as you physically and mentally can be. Step 5, and I'm really gonna stress this one, don't be Matt Mercer.
Oh, but announcer, I hear you say. Matt Mercer's a god. He is an absolute wonder child. He can do no wrong. Yeah, well, you're not Matt Mercer, and you shouldn't expect it to be Matt Mercer. You are you, and your own creativity is unique. Please be you. Don't compare yourself to others. That is unfair to you as a DM. You will do just fine on your own. You got this.
Step 6. Pay attention to the rules of D&D, but be prepared to make exceptions when you need or want to.
There are multiple times where you are just going to have to make a decision as a DM to basically flummox the rules a little bit. Like, say that your fighter just did an amazing feat. He got a giant crit in, and this giant was at 50 health, and this fighter did 49 damage. And he does like all this really cool role-playing and all that, and then the bard just slingshots the giant and kills it. Sometimes it's okay to flummox the rules or fudge a little bit of the dice so that way that giant would die to that awesome role-playing moment and it doesn't sputter out. Or if you think a rule is a little bit stupid and needs to be fixed, you can fix the rule. there's also other stuff where you can just decide that I'm not going to do that and I'm going to do that instead. It's totally up to you. You are the DM. That is your choice. Step 7. It is okay to improv once in a while. You can't account for every single last scenario that can happen. You never knew that the barbarian was going to punch the king in the face. You couldn't have accounted for that. So, what do? You improvise. You basically just do things that will help the party or just make sense in the grand scheme of things. It is entirely up to you when you need to improv, but you shouldn't rely on it too much. But when you need to improv, do it. It will save you a whole lot of headache later. And the last and final step of being a good DM, it's not just up to the DM. The players are involved as well. A lot of the time, it can feel like you are babysitting the party, that you are responsible for them, but you really aren't. They are responsible for their characters, their actions, and what they have, and what they bring to the table. You are not responsible for every individual in your group. You are responsible for the game, and kicking people out that are making the game not a good environment. It is up to the people of your party to help make the game fun, and make it an incorrigible and friendly space for everyone. It is not just on you, and it shouldn't be just on you. You are just as important as every other player. And that's all the advice I have for now. Honestly, this video is just to get my foot into the D&D community, and it's a community that I really, really want to be a part of. So please like, favorite this video, please share it with your friends and family and your other D&D friends, and please hit the subscribe button for more content like this. It is really appreciated that you guys even really like my content at all, and I honestly can't thank you guys enough that I'm able to do this now. Thank you for all the love and support, and hopefully the D&D community is very accepting and welcoming of someone like me. All right, you all have a wonderful night, and remember, rocks fall, everyone dies.